unified auditing in Oracle 12c. So Oracle Database 12 introduced unified auditing to simplify auditing. In earlier releases, defining a complex audit scenario becomes a cumbersome job. You know, with early database releases, we end up with heap of audit statements, which is difficult to manage and control. And apart from that, the many organizations felt the performance impact depends upon what auditing they are doing. But auditing seems to be a cost-intensive performance task. So it is believed that auditing on a highly accessed object in database can could lead to a lot of audit records and data generations. So to minimize the challenges on Oracle Database 12c, the auditing is always on. So there is a list of mandatory auditing activities in 12c database that cannot be turned off. So the couple of them are could be create alter drop policy, any execution on DBMS FGA or DBMS audit management package are audited. The statements being executed by SysDB, SysOper, and SysM are automatically audited in a database until even if the database is not open. These operations by SysDB, SysOper, SysASM, and other Sys users, which is introduced in Oracle, we'll talk about later in the slide, are auditable in 12c even if the auditing is not on. Another auditing feature is any changes being done to the OUDSYS tables, though those tables are read-only, but any attempt to change tables in OUDSYS schema is also auditable, even if the auditing is not on. And apart from that, we have seen the auditing records are stored in different stores, like OUD dollar table, FG dollar for fine-grained auditing, OUD dollar in SYS schemas. So in 12c, we have a common trail for all the audit logs, which is a unified underscore audit underscore trail view, which consolidates all the audit information into the one view. And you can manage auditing in Oracle Database 12c with the two new roles, which is audit underscore viewer and audit underscore admin. We'll talk about all these two roles shortly in our other slides. So moving ahead with more of in performance side. So as I said, auditing seems to be in a costly affair. So in Oracle 12c, we have improved performance using the unified audit trail mechanism, which records the audit record in a proprietary format and which is accessible directly from unified audit trail view. Other than that, beginning with 12c to support unified audit trail, Oracle has two additional named queues in the SGA. These queues record audit activity in memory. Both the queues are used in a round robin fashion, so that if when the first queue becomes full, the background process will flush those audit records into the OUDSYS schema tables. And the queue size can be defined by a unified audit SGA queue size, which is a parameter you can set, and which value can be in the range of 1 MB to 30 MB. So it depends upon how you want to tune the auditing activity. So you can configure this the queue size. Apart from that, in case if you want to flush the audit records from these queues directly to the desk on audit sys tables, you can use the flush unified audit trail command from the package, which is DBMS audit management package. The person who is executing this package should have audit admin role to execute this package. This is about Oracle Unified Auditing. Moving ahead with roles and privilege analysis.